Would you please all sit and try to maintain that upper body posture? All right, how long is the roll about our feet when we're sitting?
Flat.
Flat. Feet underneath. What's the roll about our back, Michael, when we're sitting?
Off the chair.
Off the back of the chair. All right. Faces, would you pick up your instruments, please? Okay. Viola, let's just review my violin instruments today. Overhead for putting the instrument on the shoulder when you're teaching your kiddos. Right? So we're this way. Coming down. Remove the hand. And now, to check and see if it will stay, if you can remove your left hand and bring it over. Yes, right. That was very good. Very good. All right. For my cello bass friend, for your instrument position, would you please, we're going to check three things. I want you to check that your knees are on the outside of the back.
Check your knees on the outside bounce.
Yes, very good. At the back. Very good. Now, would you bear hug your baby? Rock your baby back and forth. Very good. Very good. All right. Faces. Remember that anything goes out in front of your left foot and then you bring the baby back in. Exactly as Taylor has done. You should be able to stand freely like this and let go without your base falling. If the base falls one way, it should fall forward, not backwards, and you should be able to catch it. But it should be able to balance comfortably on your hip. If not, you may need to adjust the position of the base just a little bit. Okay? You may also need to adjust the height of your infant to make sure that nut is going to stay pretty close to your eye level. You don't want it way over your head or you're going to have to reach your head and your fingers back and up, which makes it very uncomfortable arm position. All right. Finally, the deal is if you were standing, one of the things I like to do with my little kids, you remember I said left foot forward, would you nose scroll a little over toes? It doesn't work so well when you're sitting. So with young kids, I want to have a lot of time to stand or posture tendencies a lot better. All right. Now, to put that instrument in, everybody in your instrument playing position, we're going to do this without the bow first. We have to, yes, violin, viola, and pencil your hands right at God, I will not do that. You've been shocked at it, right? It's very creepy when somebody just walks up behind you and touches you. It's strange. Pedagogical touch is what we call that, pedagogical touch. Completely acceptable if you know you have the permission of the student first, which I do, and if you don't approach them from behind. Pedagogical touch is fine. Alright, cello and bass, where does your thumb belong? Behind, the middle, or second finger. Very good. And one from the back. Everybody, would you please put your fingers down in first position? We're gonna hit the cello with it first, okay? So, we're just gonna review of all our fingers going down with E string. We're gonna play D, G, D, E, F sharp, G, A, G, F sharp, E, D. Really, one, two, ready, and. Right? But they have their little one of the questions that will be on your final exam is, what is spiral going on? Why do I keep going back and checking ball holes at different levels? Because as you develop as players, we're going to refine. Guys, this ball hole that I'm giving you is very basic. This is to get everybody started with a good basic ball hole. We're going to make revisions to it as you get older and older and develop more skills using the bow. All right. Now, let's place the bow on the string. Corbin's going to tell us if the bow is in the very center of the string, perpendicular to the bridge, what lane am I in? The middle lane, which if there are five lanes on the highway, that is lane three. What happens if we put the bow really close to the fingerboard? What lane is that? Cordell, tell us what lane. It's lane one. This is the slow lane. This is the heavy, heavy 18-wheeler lane, right? To get a good sound here, you have to use a little bit slower bow speed and more weight bow speed. Especially when they're younger. We back that up a little bit because they don't have the money. 23 for cello should be a little higher, and for bass it should be. Well, and